Hey everyone, and welcome to another daily video from Shopify Dropshipping Lifestyle. My name is Ricky Hayes, and in today's video, we're going into DPA ads versus custom audiences. All right, so let's get straight into it. So, if you aren't familiar with what a DPA ad is, it's called a dynamic product ad or catalog ad. Same thing, just different words really. And then there's CA or custom audience. I'm just used to calling it CA. There's lots of analogies out there. Basically, in relation to both of them, is that they're both used mainly for retargeting campaigns. Now, I traditionally have been doing a lot of DPA ads, and DPA ads have been wildly successful for me. They're extremely good. They're on autopilot. Been using automated rules. I'm using more automated rules, and that's something that I'll be teaching in my premium group more and more in the future. But with DPA, I have been doing a lot more custom audience retargeting, and I wanted to discuss the differences with them and sort of help you understand a bit further. So a DPA ad is really handy because it is mostly on autopilot. That's what's cool about it, because what it does is it connects to your catalog. So this is your catalog here, and these are some catalogs. And what you can do is obviously, once you've made a catalog, you can then actually make a dynamic product ad. It'll prompt you to make one. And basically from there, so if we go create ad, I think it may or may not allow me, but I'll just briefly show you how this works. The good thing with, as I said, DPA ad is it's more around using carousel images, because your catalog, it pulls the images straight from your store. So we're going to see the product set, which is your actual catalog and any catalogs that your ad account has access to, because you set it in your business settings. And then you have these options here. So you can actually use custom audiences in a catalog ad as well if you really wanted. I personally haven't. I've used just these options. And by default, it's going to use 14-day delivery. I set it at the start when you're first doing it, especially when you're starting to 180-day. And then over time, you want to narrow it down. Like if you're spending thousands upon thousands on ads a day, then you can go down to add to basket but not purchased, or you can go a custom combination of view content, add to basket but not purchased. You can do all of these combinations. Once you start scaling, then you go from 180 days and you go further back, okay? But the thing is with carousel is it's mainly aimed at retargeting people based on the individual session, their individual session of, you know, whatever products they've seen. And so the pixel stores that, and then it'll say, okay, well, you've looked at these five products, I'll re-show you these five products. It's very personal, and that's why DPA works very well. It's very customized to that individual. All right, and that's good, but all the same, I have found that as of recently, that with DPA ads, they still work very well, but video is becoming more and more and more prominent because people just seem to like video more. Instagram works well, obviously, with images very well still, of course, but video is just, it is becoming more and more of the current standard. So with that being said, that's what brings me onto custom audience retargeting, okay? And custom, like what you can do here, you can be very specific if you want, but custom audience retargeting just gives you that extra layer. So like, because in here you do have controls, but you can basically just do various forms of pixel events. Whereas with a custom audience retargeting, you can even do a DPA ad using the custom audience, as you've seen, is you can be very more specific and granular about what you do. And obviously this depends completely on how far you are in your journey of your marketing and how specific you want to be. So, you know, you can exclude. So you could say people that, let's say, visited my entire website and then visited one specific page, or you can exclude that page. You can do all of that. And so what you do, the same as with a DPA ad, is at the start, you generally start with view content because you're going to have the most view content. You do 180 days. Two reasons. You can use that for lookalikes, and then you can use that for retargeting. Okay, and the real added bonus, I mean, in DPA you can do this, but I prefer to do this on a more manual basis, just for a bit more control, is you make a new campaign, and the campaign, so let's just make one now just to show you, is you can use video, okay? Really sort of hammers home, you get that control from the start, video, whatever. Anyway, and yes, cool story. Feet are dirty. Anyway, so you put then the custom audience in here. So you can use the save audience. Yes. Where's my purchase? There he is. And so, you know, you use the custom audience. So if I was to use this, now I've got a custom audience, so it's very specific and I can control all of this. Again, you can sort of do that in a DPA, but doing it this way from the start just removes other factors that may contribute. And then once you get to the actual ad, then it's like you're making a cold traffic ad. It's basically you just have that extra layer of control and you then can choose a video. Now, with you doing this, then you can choose exactly the same video or a slightly different variation of the video. Okay, so what my recommendation now to people is definitely do DPA. So once you start getting a bit of traction, getting a few sales, make a DPA ad, connect your catalog, set it to $5 a day. You'll be surprised. You might get a sale or two just from a simple retargeting ad that's completely on autopilot. I've got videos on that. But then once you start getting higher, then you want to start split testing your DPA ad, going from 180 day down to 7 day, and then 1 day. And then you do this sort of sequence of 1, 3, 7, 14, and you do the same with custom audience. So 1, 3, 7, 14 is, I've pretty much got up to 14, and you progressively go, I'm changing it now so I can try and increase my ROAS, so that my first retargeting of anything I'm going to be doing over the following months is that it's just like, hey, we see that you're interested in the product, return now, no discount, they just come back, okay, free sale, it's just a reminder, and then the second one you give them a discount. And it's the same with this, is that the one, once you start getting to that point, you have a really high winning product, what you do is you have, you know, all your apps and that I've gone through, but you do this 1, 3, 7, 14, and you do it all under VC for that product. And then you just say, hey, we see your interest in this product, return now, here's a link, come back, buy. All right, and then 3 days, because what it's going to do is, so 1 day is going to be instant, 3 days is then, okay, we're sorry to see you go, return now, and get a 10% discount code, offer lasts 24 hours only, and blah, blah, and then you'll get some sales there, and then 7 day, 15%, and then 14, 20%. Okay, and so you can see how you reminded them 4 times on Facebook. At that time, you'll have probably sent the abandoned cart email flows, SMS flows, messenger flows, and between pretty much all 4 of those avenues, or 5 including DPA, you have nearly 5 avenues where the customer just can't escape you, and it's just, they're going to come back. And remember, this is where you're going to make the real money. All right, so that's pretty much it. It's not a huge amount to it. It's just making simple custom audiences based on your product. So if you just, again, go website traffic, I can't do it here, which is kind of annoying, but you can use the URL, or what I do now is I use the content ID, which is in the back end of Shopify. Once you go to URL up the top there, that after the last backslash, there'll be this unique number, similar, let's say something like this. You copy that, that's the content ID. That's specifically unique for that product. Use the content ID. It's better than URL, because sometimes with URL, you can get overlap. And so using the content ID just sort of guarantees that that's correct. And then just set up that sequence, set up your retargeting campaign, leave it wide open with age, genders, location, and just see what works well. Because you might find one day, it might be mobile, and then the third day it might be desktop. You don't know, because it might be that just over time people just do different things and you can find correlations. Then once you now understand that, then you start split testing the different ages, different genders, different locations, different placements, okay, stuff like that. So I just wanted to provide a video on that. I am going to be providing a lot more of this in my premium group, okay? So I've decided that, you know, like with these free videos, I really want to give these out, but I really am pushing for people to join my premium group because I want people to really invest in themselves, to really, you know, ensure that they get that success. The people in the group, in my group, are really getting success. There's myself and multiple other experts who are there to help. You learn about Google, you learn about Facebook, you learn about product research, you learn about pretty much every aspect to get you started. Stupidly cheap price, and you'll absolutely love it. There's a link down below, all right? But I also wanted to say, if you did like today's video, hit the like button. Don't forget to comment, and the subscribe button and the notification bell so you get daily updates straight to your phone so you can watch it however you like. There's a cheat sheet down below as well, okay? So I always recommend everyone get that cheat sheet. It's completely free. All you have to do is just go to the URL, get your free cheat sheet, and you're good to go. It'll help you get started. It's what I use when I make a new store. It's extremely useful, and it's... if you have any questions, just join my free group, Shop by Dropshipping Lifestyle. Ask questions there. The group really helps each other. And then obviously, if you do want my premium support, then that's when you want to join my gold class group, okay? But that's pretty much it from today's video. Again, I will be making videos, I've decided now, about 2 to 3 a week, probably about 3 a week tops, just because I obviously, just with time, as well as, you know, I think 3 is a good amount to give you good information. You know, stuff like this is very valuable. This is very good stuff. If there's other links down below as well, I should quickly add, you know, if you are interested in a specific hour with me, just helping you, I usually run over an hour because I don't really care, and just to make sure you're all good, then, you know, there's links down below for that as well, okay? But don't forget to join my free group, follow me on Instagram, there's links down below. And let's all start making some real cash in Q4, okay? It's starting to really kick in. We're all going to really start making some good cash. Thank you very much for your time today. You all have a lovely day and take care. Goodbye.